dear student, in my last video we discussed pollination and two types of pollination. Today we will discuss agents of pollination, that is biotic and abiotic. Abiotic agents means these are the non-living agent which include water and wind, that is physical factor. Biotic agent, it includes living agent. About 80% of plant require the help of other living, moving creature such as insect, birds, bat, snail. They are sustain our ecosystem, produce natural resources by helping plants to reproduce. In my last video, we discussed two types of pollination, self-pollination and cross-pollination. In self-pollination, there is no need of pollinating agent. But in case of cross-pollination, there is need of pollinating agent. So, in case of cross-pollination, there is two types of agents. First one is abiotic agents and second one is biotic agencies. A biotic agencies, it's a anemophilous means a wind, hydrophilous means water. Biotic agencies, it includes entomophily, that is insect, ornithophilous, it's a birds. Then next one, it's a chiropterophily means the bat, melecophily means the snail, and the myrmecophily means the ant pollination. As in this we study biotic and abiotic agencies. Biotic, the animals carried out process of pollination, that is the insect and the birds. Abiotic, that is a non-living things, physical factors carried out the process of pollination, it by means of the wind and the water. In this topic we concentrate the point anemophilous forms of pollination, that is wind pollination, hydrophilous means water pollination, entomophily insect pollination, ornithophilous bird pollination, and chiropterophily means the bat pollination. So let's start the first, that is wind pollination. Most of the important crop plant are wind pollinated. These include wheat, rice, corn, rye, barley and oats. The palm plant are also wind pollinated. For to carry out wind pollination, the flower itself modified, that is adaptation in anemophilous flower. So let's see the characteristic of such a flower. The flower are small. You can see in this image the flower are small, inconspicuous, colorless, without nectar and fragrance, means odor is absent. The pollen grain are light in weight, dry and produced very large in number to increase the chance of pollination. This pollen grain, it's a smooth pollen grain. Next characteristic is the stigma is feathery. You can see here the stigma, it's a feather like to catch the pollen which is carried on by wind. Next, it's a anther. This anther, it's a versatile anther. It's a versatile anther. There is a presence of the long filament. There is a presence of long filament. The next one we see, the second form of pollination, that is the water pollination. It's known as a hydrophily. The pollination which is carried out by water called the hydrophilous form of pollination, found in 30 genera of aquatic monocots. It's observed in case of Vallisneria, Zostera and Ceratophyllia. Let's see the adaptations in Hydrophilus flower. The flower are small, inconspicuous and unisexual. Perianth and other floral parts are unwettable. Pollen grain are long and unwettable due to presence of mucilage. Nectar and fragrance are lacking in flower. This Hydrophilus is of two type. First one, hypohydrophily. Second, epihydrophily. So let's start. The first point, it's a hypohydrophily. Pollination occurs below the surface of water. Below the surface of water, this pollination is occurred. The pollen grain are heavier than water, so it's a sink down and caught by stigma of female flower. It is commonly observed in case of Zostera, that is known as the sea grass. The pollen grain, it's a long ribbon like and without exile. The second type of pollination, it's known as the epihydrophilus. The pollen grain float on surface of water, reach on stigma of female flower. It is reach on stigma of female flower. It's commonly observed in case of Vallisneria. This Vallisneria, it is the submerged dioecious freshwater plant. Dioecious means what? Male and female flower, it's on separate plant. After maturity, the male flower float on the surface of water. The female flower, it's having the long coiled pedicel. You can see here, there is a presence of long coiled pedicel, which undergoes uncoiling at the time of maturity. This water pollination, this image, it shows the water pollination. There is a presence of the long coiled pedicel and the bright color flower. In case of the Hydrophilus form of pollination, the significant one, there is an absence of exiles. The next we started, that's biotic agent. It includes living agent. About 80% of plants require the help of other living moving creatures such as insect, birds, bat and snail. They are sustained our ecosystem and produce natural resources by helping plant to reproduce. Means for the reproduction, to work out the process of reproduction, formation of seed, this agent, it plays a very significant role. In biotic agent, the first phenomena we see, that's entomophilus. The pollination which is carried out by insect is called as entomophily. The insect like moth, butterflies, beetles, flies and bees. Bees are the most common pollinating agent. So let's see the floral adaptations for entomophilus. The flower, basically the flower are large, often bright colored. The flower produce the sweet scent or odor. There is a presence of nectar glands here. The stigma, it's a rough due to presence of hair, or it's sticky due to mucilage secretion. The pollen grain, this pollen grain are spiny and surrounded by a yellow sticky substance called a pollen kit. In some of plant, There is a special adaptation for insect visitor to help in cross pollination. Its example is salvia. The salvia shows liver mechanism or turnpike mechanism. So let's see what's a phenomena. This image indicates the salvia flower. In this flower, there is a presence of the significant characteristic. There is presence of a stamen. But this stamen, it is a bifurcated stamen. That is, the lower stamen, it's a sterile one, and upper stamen, it's a fertile one. When the insect come in contact with the flower, then the pollen grain, it is dusted on the backside of the insect body. When these bees are visited from one flower to another flower, that time this mature stigma get transferred. The pollen, this pollen grain which is present on the backside of insect body, that pollen get transferred to the stigma. It get transferred to the stigma. So this image indicate that is the stamen. This stamen, it's a bifurcated stamen. The lower one, it is the sterile anther, and upper one, it's a fertile anther. So it is called as the turnpike mechanism or the liver mechanism. The second phenomena we see, that is the characteristic which is present as the bees are the most common pollinating agent. So let's see what's the characteristic is there in flower. The flower are large and attractive. It's a bright colored, pleasant fragrance and nectar. Pollen grain spiny and the stigma is sticky. It's observed in case of bougainvillea, that is petaloid brachycere, salvia, passion flower. The next form of the biotic agency pollination we see, that is the birds. It's known as ornithophilus. The pollination which is carried out by birds, it's known as ornithophily. Only a few birds are specialized for pollination. They are usually have the small size birds. You can see in this image, the birds are small in size but having the long beak. It's an example, it's a sunbirds and the hummingbirds. Some ornithophilus plants are the Bombax callistemon, that is a bottle brush, and the butea. For to carry out the pollination, the flowers itself modified. So let's see the characteristic which is present in such a flower. The flower are usually bright colored, large. The flower are usually bright colored, large, and the showy. The corolla, it is a tubular. It's a tube like, or it may be the funnel shape. The flower are large. You can see all the flower are large, thick, and fleshy floral parts is here. They secrete the profuse or the dilute nectar. As these birds do not have the good sense of smell, so the bird pollinated flower usually have the little odor. The flower provide the fluid nectar in great quantities than the insect. Hummingbirds pollinated flowers usually have long and tubular corolla. The pollen grain which is present, this pollen grain, it is a large and the sticky pollen grain, spiny pollen grain is here. So this image indicates the bottle brush plants, that is a callistemon. The next form of form of pollination is Chiropterophily. In this form of pollination, the pollination which is carried out by bat, it's known as the Chiropterophily. The bat can transport the pollen over long distance, sometime several kilometers. So let's see the floral adaptations for such a plant, for such form of pollinations. The flowers are dull color with strong fragrance. They secrete abundant nectar. Chiropterophilus plant are nocturnal, means that plant open its flower during night time. Flower produced large amount of edible pollen grain. So this pollen grain, it is a large amount of pollen grain which is stick on the head region or the entire body of the bat. This it's observed in case of Anthocephalus, Kinglia, Pinnata. This Anthocephalus, it is also called as the kadam tree. You can see this image. This is the flower of kadam tree, that is Anthocephalus. And the second image, it indicates the Kinglia pinnata, that is also called as the sausage tree. Here we completed agents of pollination, that is biotic and abiotic. I think so you have understand. Thanks for watching my video. We will continue further part in next video. Thank you.